Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craftroom, and in this video I'm going to show you a super fun faux stitching technique. For this two-step technique I'm going to use Sakura Micron Pens in black in two sizes, and I'm going to start with a 0.1 and 0.8, and I'm going to use a ruler, any ruler will do. And I start with the biggest tip and start making dots. I space them out with about the same space in between and just make a row of dots. I leave a bit of space in between the rows, but you can make a complete row too. And at the end I go back and forth with the dots, just like you would with real stitches, to make sure they don't come loose. And just so you know, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and you can find the full list of supplies and more info on my blog. And then I take the fine tip and start connecting the dots, and it's that easy. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And then I just add little lines at the end, like it's a loose thread that is sticking out. For the next dots I'm going to take the 0.5 pen and I make the dots pretty straight down. So I hold the pen straight above the paper and let it land straight down to get the best dots. I make the row with dots spaced out a bit more and another row next to it in between the spaces of the previous dots. And then I take the fine tip again and I connect the dots from the two rows, making a zigzag. And I'm going to make another combination with dots really close together and a few spaced out a bit more, and I'm going to make two rows. I've been doing this for ages and I love the almost real look you can get in a real simple way. And no needles, so it's all safe. And you don't have to carry around or store a sewing machine, which saves space for other crafting goodies. So that's all good things, right? And then I connect the dots again with the fine tip, making zigzags and straight stitch lines. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? Available on smartphone and desktop. And I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes, polls and such, so you can come check that out if you like. And another back and forward stitch. So here you already have a few fun ways to add faux stitches. And now the freehand doodle stitch. It works a bit the other way around. I have my two pens and a bunch of flowers, and I put the flowers on the card. I want them to make them sort of dangling from the top. And now I'm going to start with a fine tip and make a line. You can also use a ruler for this. I like to do it freehand so it looks more playful. And then I'm going to add the dots with a bigger pen, so it's just the other way around. And you can get some lines this way that you can't get with a regular ruler. I glue the flowers in place when I'm done with the stitching, so I can add it a bit over the line. I also added another zigzag and some more lines and add the dots in various ways to create some different looks. I add the dots in groups of 3 and 2, and on a curvy line you can just add them any way you want to. I glued the last two flowers to the card too, and I add a little freehand doodle line along the side. I take the fine tip pen for this and I go back and forth a bit, or make little knots here and there. Adding some black along the edges can make a project or a color pop a bit. And here are my two cards. I added some doodle lines on the flowers to make them blend in with the rest, and some more doodle lines on the other card too. I hope you liked the video and maybe you want to give this technique a try. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting!